Very good morning to all of you. On behalf of Bangalore branch of SIRC of ICAI, I welcome you for the one-day seminar on tax audit and ICDS. There are about five sessions we are planned under the guidance of CA Naveen Kariwal. Now we'll begin with the program, the inauguration of the today's seminar. We have with us our chief guest, CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao, a chairman of SIRC of ICAI, all the way who is came from Hyderabad. I request Chairman Bangalore Branch, CA Seven Guduthur, to escort the today's chief guest, Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao, and also our SIRC member, CA Babu K. Tewar, Kota S. Srinivas. I welcome with all the flower bouquet. I request Chairman to welcome the gathering.
Chief guest of today's seminar, CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao, the Chairman of SIRC of ICAI, the Treasurer of SIRC of ICAI, CA Babu K. Tewar, the immediate past Chairman of SIRC of ICAI, CA Kota S. Srinivas, Program Coordinator, CA Naveen Kariwal, the eminent set of speakers of today's seminar, my colleagues in the Managing Committee and the entire gathering of my professional friends, a very good morning to each and every one of you, and welcome to this seminar on tax audit and ICDS. Well, we are glad to have amongst us today the energetic and the experienced chairman of SIRC of ICAI, CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao, who with his applaudable caliber and unstinted efforts has been working for the cause of the profession, the members and the students at SIRC of ICAI. A huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, to CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao as we welcome him to this inaugural session. We also have with us the past chairmen of Bangalore branch, CA Babu K. Tewar, who is presently the treasurer of SIRC, and the past chairman of SIRC of ICAI, CA Kota S. Srinivas. We welcome both the representatives of SIRC from Karnataka to this inaugural session. Get updated to stay relevant. In fact, these are the only five words, get updated to stay relevant, that made the Bangalore branch of ICAI organize this one-day seminar on tax audit and ICDS. And it is one of the main reasons why more than 400 delegates, more than 400 members have shown keen interest by registering to this seminar. CBDT has notified a new set of rules through which it came out with a lot of changes to the Form 3CD, 3CB, and 3CA. A lot of new reporting requirements, verification requirements, primarily pertaining to GST, SFT, transfer pricing, and cash transactions related reporting requirements. In today's seminar, we have roped in the best of the best speakers, CA Gururaj Acharya, CA KK Chaitanya, CA S. Subramanian, CA Prashant GS, Naveen Kariwal, Deepak Chopra, and Nitin Kumar P, who will be here to take a deep dive into all these changes, not just these changes, but also various other issues, practical problems, critical problems that are associated while we are doing an audit, a tax audit, and also performing our duties in relation to reporting under ICDS. I'm delighted to inform you that the seminar structure has been completely put together with the able guidance of CA Naveen Kariwal, who has always been showing very keen interest in the branch activities and has been holding the hands with the branch in putting together seminars like this. I welcome CA Naveen Kariwal as well in his absentia. Let me also take this privilege to welcome all the participants who have assembled here and who have shown keen interest to learn more about the tax audit report and the issues pertaining to ICDS. Well, before I conclude, I would like to state that the ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in times of comfort, but where he stands in times of challenges. So, my dear ladies and gentlemen, this is the seminar which I'm sure will 100% help each and every one of you in achieving and embracing these changes. Welcome each and every one of you. Over to the secretary.
Thank you, Chairman. It's a privilege to introduce the today's chief guest, CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao, who hails from the Hyderabad, Telangana, has unanimously been elected as Chairman of Southern India Regional Council of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India for the year 2018-19. Born in the humble agriculture family in Ungathuru village in Mandal, Krishna district, Andhra Pradesh, he has risen to this position with his sheer dedication, be it in education, professional service and service to the society through various other forums. An affable personality, C.A. Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao did his schooling in his native place, college in Guntur and Ganavaram, and pursued his passion to the Chartered Accountancy course in Hyderabad. Enrolled as an associate member of ICAI in 1991, he continued his employment with erstwhile APSCB until entering into professional practice in March 1995. During his two terms between 2007 to 2013, he served as secretary, vice chairman and then chairman of the Hyderabad branch of SIRC of ICAI in 2011-12. To his credit in ICI, he was in the helm of affairs when the Hyderabad branch of SIRC of ICI celebrated its golden jubilee of its formation in the year 2011-12 and also received the best branch award among large category of branches from SIRC of ICI. Presently as chairman of SIRC in this year, he is leading SIRC when it is celebrate the golden jubilee conference on 31st August and 1st September 2018. He is efficient and organized administrator with over 9 years of experience in industry and 23 years of experience in practice with record of working to very high standards. Blessed with understanding wife and loving children, his son is a graduate from MS from Indiana University and daughter pursuing CA final. With this brief introduction, I present before you today chief guest CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao. Welcome you sir. We have with other two members, they are all you know, C.A. Babu Ketevar, he is presently serving as the treasurer of SIRC of ICI. And C.A. Kotaya Srinivas, he is immediate past chairman of the SIRC of ICI. Now, begin with the inauguration session, I request dignitaries on the dais and request managing committee members of Bangalore branch and the speakers for the today's seminar to join with us for the formally inaugurating the seminar.
Yaeshah supteshu jagrati Yaeshah supteshu jagrati Kamam, 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 usho, usho, nirmimanaha, nirmimanaha, tadeva shukram, tadeva shukram, tada brahma, tadeva mritamuchyate, tasmin lokaha, tasmin lokaha, shataha, Sarve taduna tyati kashchana tyati kashchana Etat dvaita
Before addressing by the chief guest, let's we can hear from the treasurer of SIRC, Babu Ketevar.
Chairman of the SIRC, C.A. Adusumilli Garu, first time visited Bangalore branch, so welcome you sir, as a chairman. Past chairman, Kota Srinivas, dynamic chairman of Bangalore branch, C.A. Seven Kuduthur, secretary, office bearers and friends, good morning to you all. So today tax audit, what we are doing, planning, it will be different what we have done earlier. I think department want to do their work by us. They are expecting whatever they want to do, everything done by the chartered accountant. And earlier tax audit means we thought only income tax. Now trend has been changed. We need to know all the acts. Reconciliation between GST and financial is very, very difficult. please start early, complete early, and work has been increased a lot. But fees, you need to increase according to your work. Please maintain timesheet and send the checklist to the clients first, what he has to do first. So it helps lots. Generally, I have seen that no, they bring everything to us. We have to do accounting work. Instead of that, please see that checklist to be reached to client first. Let him complete and come and see that fees has to be increased. I am the one of the committee for screening committee for one of the leading cooperative bank. I have seen 3 years, generally, you know, we'll see 3 years balance sheet analyze. Indeed, all the expenditure has been increased. Salary, office, everything, except audit fees. So that should not be happen. See that, and you ought to convince the or educate the client what we are doing work. You ought to work it, do what and all you are doing work list, and prepare that and give one report to him what you have done. They should not feel that just you are signing balance sheet. That has to be taken care. So an article training has to be given article students. We have Bangalore branch. We are organizing next week one program for students, exclusively for students from morning to evening. Please send your articles for registration and let them be also be trained. And health, very, very important. I have seen that many members work from morning 5 a.m. to night 12 o'clock, but our clients sit in AC room and enjoy the life. That should not be happen. See that to be clients also face the heat. And let him work all the whatever requirement of as per tax audit and prepare and come to us for audit. So you ought to be prepared for that. I hope you'll enjoy tax audit period. And I thank for chairman giving opportunity for this. Thank you.
Thank you, Babu sir. Now I request today chief guest C. Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao to address the gathering.
Very good morning, Mr. Seven Guthur, Chairman of Bangalore Branch, CA Babu Kittevar, Treasurer of SSFSA, my colleague in the Region Council, immediate past Chairman, Kota S. Srinivas, CA Ravendra Kore, Secretary of Bangalore Branch, CA Sivaram Shankar Bhatt, Vice Chairman of Bangalore Branch, immediate past Chairman CA Srimati Geeta, past Chairman of SIRC Branch CA Vishnu Bharat Garu, other managing CA Bojraj T. Shetty Garu, Treasurer, Bangalore Branch, and other managing committee members of Bangalore Branch, CA Gururaj Acharya Garu, today's speaker, and all eminent resource persons, distinguished invitees, senior members, fellow members, good morning all of you. I am happy to be here as a chairman of SIRC. It is my first visit to Bangalore branch. Today's topic is very hot topic, which is needed because after a notification of tax audit, again they included some paragraphs which we have to take care of GST and service tax, all these things in a different and proper way. Let me thank the organizer for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts through my inaugural address. Let me at the outset record my appreciation and convey my congratulations to the organizers for conceptualizing this seminar, covering the major areas and facets of tax audit with innovative presentation through live demonstration and ICDS. The resource persons of eminence to share their expertise would add immense value to the proceedings, and every one of us would have feast of knowledge with enrichment and enlightenment on the subjects. I, along with you all, eagerly look forward for their presentation. I offer my sincere thanks to all the resource persons for their gracious presence. You are well aware that to talk 1 hour, they have to work at least 4 hours. And I recognize the presence of Mr. Naveen Kairwale, who who has taken as a coordinator of this program. As you are well aware, ours is only one profession that requires constant and continuous and consistent updation of knowledge. This is invariably due to our areas of professional activities revolving around the financial and economic scenario, witnessing intermittent changes in the laws through legislations, notifications, circulars of various departments by the government, both central and state governments. No other profession in India does have regularity in changes of laws introduced by the government. Friends, our accountancy profession continues to draw the attention of the government, be it in taxation angle, corporate law angle, assurance and auditing standards, and so on. Besides, our profession faces newer challenges coupled with opportunities in the form of new professional areas like insolvency and bankruptcy code, valuation standards. One area which year after year witnesses changes in the procedures and compliance is tax audit. The Central Board of Direct Taxes in newer concepts, newer compliance standards introduce different statistics and forms, and we the professionals have not only to adapt and adopt the prescribed procedures, but also the onerous task of guiding and enlightening our clients as to the records that needs to be provided by them to us for conducting the tax audit in the manner expected by the authorities concerned. This is the first challenge in disseminating the new laws to our clientele. As you are well aware, once you do tax audit, only 5%. Now the scrutiny is only 5%. It means 95% is being accepted by the government department based on our reports. So that is the respect, or you can say honor, or we can say even dependency they are giving to us. So we need to be very cautious. The next challenge is in terms of collating and consolidation of the information provided by the clients, identify gray areas, obtaining further information, ultimately completing the audit with the due compliance in the prescribed format. The third and most difficult challenge is to complete the audit within the time permitted by the department. It is to our credit that we, the allied professionals, and having extensive and expert knowledge on tax aspects, continue to excel in our professional performance and act in a manner appreciated by both the SC and the department. It is in this respect, seminars of this nature play a vital role in updating and refreshing the knowledge of our members with updated requirements, and it is here the resource persons play a vital role in enhancing our intrinsic knowledge. I would on this occasion stress the importance of documentation. You will all agree with me, because unless otherwise we have documentation properly, tomorrow we cannot save our skin, and we need to have our documentation properly, and we need to document it also. So we need to train our articles with proper documentation. Therefore, I would urge upon you to look after two aspects. One, to prepare and concise and comprehensive documentation, and the other is presentation of the audit report with necessary disclosures as may warrant with reference to any shortcoming and risk management, if any. I am sure the proceedings in the technical session covering the entire ambit of tax audit would be a revelation and realize the objective with which this seminar is being organized. Coming to the topics of ICDS, it is interlinked to the tax audit report as requirements as to gain or losses arising due to ICDS are to be made in income tax return forms, and since information in income tax forms are kept very brief, hence detailed information may have to be given during the course of assessment proceedings, if any, and also information has to be given in tax audit report in form of 3CD under Section 44A to incorporate gains and losses arising due to ICDS. The session on ICDS is therefore would be an interesting and enlivening session, and I congratulate the organizers for intertwining both tax audit and ICDS in today's program. I'm happy that they have, the response is very good, and after 450 registration, they have stopped the registrations also. That shows our curiosity in learning the subject. I therefore, I place on record my appreciation to all the participants, which shows our continuous professional education is must and is needed. While I have dealt on the subject today, I also feel my burden duty, my bounden duty as the chairman of SIRC to share few of my thoughts among this August gathering. As you are well aware, that SIRC is conducting Golden Jubilee Regional Conference. I was the chairman of Hyderabad branch in 2011-12. I was very lucky to hold Golden Jubilee celebrations of the branch. Again, I'm very lucky to hold this Golden Jubilee Regional Conference. That's why, because when we thought of conducting this program, we expected only 2,000 members would have conducted in Silpakala Vedika, which is also good venue. And their cost is very, very nominal. But whereas when you are expecting 3,000 to 3,500 delegates, we have no option like you. You have good option in here in palace grounds. We have no option except HSCC, which is a 7-star property. So I was forced to go for HSCC. Accordingly, the fees was fixed around 4,000 plus. I would like to bring to your kind notice that whatever we fix the fees is not at all sufficient for two lunch and one dinner. We are organizing a more than almost a crore sponsorship, only because we need to deliver the things, and I am sure that we will get sponsors. And here we also spoke to some hotels wherein we organized for 24 hour check-in from some hotels. Other hotels are 12 noon check-out. So you please, all details have been uploaded in the SIRC website. If you have any assistance, you can also contact our Hyderabad branch and SIRC office, which we have already given in the SIRC newsletter. I look forward to welcome you all in Hyderabad, because definitely we will enjoy, and all the topics are chosen were very, very relevant. In fact, somebody called me and asked me, why don't you put that succession planning for particularly in HUF? So then I contacted Dr. Girish Ahuja. He's the right person, because one chartered accountant called me from rural Mafsal area. He said, I charge only on that planning around 3 lakhs rupees fees. It's a good subject. Accordingly, whatever subjects we have, Susan is very, very useful to small and medium enterprises. So I welcome you all, and we have even online registration is available. I request you to do online registration so that your GST invoice can be raised. So we have taken care of that. If you have any issues, we can talk to our treasurer and our immediate past chairman, Kotha Srinivas, who is a digital man, because whatever in SIRC, whatever, because we thought it is a continuous period. When Srinivas started, I said we will continue it, because it should be a continuous things. Whatever he started, we are continuing the same thing. Coming to SIRC website, we have given a lot of information every day. Whatever presentations are being done, whatever CP programs, and it is being uploaded in the SIRC website. Even SIRC YouTube, you can find all CP programs. Even live, you can see, you can download and you can view it. I request you to just go through them. And any suggestions are there, you are most welcome to enhance our capabilities. So I look forward to you to Hyderabad and to participate in Golden Jubilee on August 3rd. I request all the members, because the Extension date was announced somewhere on 27th. By that time, we have completed 80% of our returns. I appeal all our members to ask your clients to complete to come to your office before 25th so that you can join with us in the Golden Jubilee Region Conference. Because what I observed, if you ask your clients, definitely they will come. That is what I am following in my personal view. In my personal office, I am seeing that whenever we are calling, clients are coming. You have to inculcate that habit to the clients, then definitely they will listen to us. We are the financial doctors. See, some people will come to us, which they don't even tell to their wife, they will tell to us. They will take their our help. Yesterday, it is not actually a joke. My friends, because the other day one of my client came. He is actually applied for, he is actually in trouble. His all properties were seized. His daughter marriage was fixed on August 16th. When he came to me, I have seen some refunds has to be realized. We forwarded it, we got around 46 lakhs. You tell me just, are we not justified as a financial doctor? He said only one thing, sir, I am thankful to you. Because of you, my daughter, I am able to perform my daughter. That is commitment of any chartered accountant to our client. Friends, we are also planning to remove the difficulties in the 11th hour to our professional friends. We are also planning to arrange around 10 to 12 systems with Wi-Fi facility at the venue, so that if you want, you can file returns from there also. So this we are trying. And CABF, what Kota Srinivas started, we are also continuing, and I appeal to all members to contribute your thing. Whoever gives 1 lakh and above, we will be displaying their names. We already displayed their names in SIRC website and also SIRC premises. I also request the branch, please, whoever gives lakh and above, you please display their name boards in the in branch also. Because when members are, families are approaching us, we feel very bad of their situation. Some people are coming to us, they don't have a single property, they don't have any income, and they are only surviving because whatever institute is giving, 5,000 or 10,000, with that they are surviving. So kindly, and I also appeal to all members, kindly take care of your term insurance. Today, insurance, thrift insurance has gone. Now, term insurance, because you can see 65 years to 75, 85 years policies are there, be careful. There are, we are also talking to some insurance agencies, and which we will present to the ICAI. We will take approval and we will also host in our SIRC website once it is approved by ICAI. Apart from that, I also request you to kindly term insurance is must for all of us. Kindly take care of that, because we need to take care of our families. So I know that you are very busy with your professional work, and also you need to take care of your personal things also. Please consider about your term insurance. I once again congratulate the organizers for arranging this, and I am happy to be here. This type of seminars will definitely enrich our knowledge. With this, I conclude. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thank you, Chairman SIRC, Shri Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao. I will not take much time, as our next session speaker is waiting here. That is another than Guraja Charsha. I would like to take this opportunity to, on behalf of Bangor branch and on behalf of Managing Committee of Bangor branch, I would like to thank the today's chief guest, CA Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao. I request dignitaries on the dais and also request managing committee members to come forward and to do the felicitation to the today's chief guest, C. Adusumilli Venkateswara Rao. So thank the treasurer of SRC, CA Babu Ketevar, and CA Kota S. Srinivas. I thank all the members for joining this inaugural sessions.